At Emily and James' house, work continues. Today, Emily invited Mr. Jones, the carpenter, to design her future kitchen. Mr. Jones suggested different ways of placing the kitchen furniture, and Emily's constant questions didn't seem to bother him. He assured Emily that by late afternoon, he would email James detailed plans with his suggestions so they could choose what worked for them or propose changes. Mr. Jones knows that to win a job, he must impress his clients from the first meeting, and in this, he has a powerful ally, the free application Sweet Home 3D. Sweet Home 3D allows cabinet makers to visualize the final product before construction begins, reducing misunderstandings and ensuring the cabinets meet their customers' expectations. Using a distance meter or a tape measure, take precise measurements of the entire kitchen area, including wall lengths, ceiling height, and any existing fixtures or features that might impact cabinet placement. Alternatively, you can request a detailed floor plan if one is available. In Sweet Home 3D, you only need to design the kitchen, not the entire house. Focus on creating the walls and the areas where the kitchen furniture will be placed. Additionally, include any windows and doors that might affect the placement of the cabinets. In our previous lesson, we designed a kitchen plan. Now, let's explore how a carpenter or cabinet maker can effectively communicate this plan to their clients. We'll begin by using the Create Rooms button. Simply click on it, and then hit OK to close the information window that might pop up. Left-click on the starting point of the room and move the pointer to the right. Press the Enter key to input the exact length of 4 meters in the dimensions box, then press Enter again. For the next side of the room, repeat this process to enter the length. In Emily's kitchen, where all sides are 4 meters, you simply press Enter 3 times until the last side meets the first. Finally, press the Escape key located in the upper left corner of the keyboard to create the room. After the creation of the room, activate the Create Walls button on the toolbar. Press OK to close the info window and double-click on the room to create the walls. To create a more immersive experience for our clients, we'll virtually remove any walls that aren't needed for the kitchen layout. First, click the Select Objects in Plan button on the toolbar. Then, left-click on the first wall to select it. While holding down the Shift key, select the other wall and press the Delete key. This allows us to capture stunning visuals of the entire space from various angles and distances. Imagine being able to walk through your dream kitchen without any obstructions. This approach provides a much clearer picture of the final design and how it integrates with the surrounding areas. Before proceeding, we'll add the door on the right wall, as it may impact the placement and distribution of the kitchen furniture. In the last lesson, we explored designing a functional kitchen layout. Now, let's see how a carpenter or cabinet maker can effectively communicate this plan to their clients using Sweet Home 3D. For better organization, let's design the kitchen on a separate level. Right-click inside the floor plan and choose Add Level at the same elevation. Double-click Level 1 and rename it Layout 1. Similarly, double-click on Level 0 and rename it to Floor Plan. Now, with the Layout 1 level active, we can start designing. Let's put our skills from the last lesson to use by inserting the kitchen cabinets. For a quick reminder on importing furniture, revisit the Homeowner's Guide to Kitchen Design in Sweet Home 3D course. To ensure clarity in your design, it's essential to enter accurate measurements. First, we'll make Level Floor Plan invisible by double-clicking its tab and unchecking Viewable in the window that appears. Then, we'll select the Kitchen tab so that only the kitchen is visible in our design. Activate the Create Dimensions toolbar button. Hover over the face of each cabinet and double-click to create the measurement, setting the dimension extension randomly. Repeat this step for each kitchen cabinet. To adjust the dimensions, use the lasso technique to select the dimensions on one side. Right-click on one of the selected dimensions and choose Modify Dimensions from the menu. In the window that appears, change the extension line to 10 cm and select Visible in 3D View. We'll repeat the same actions for the dimensions on the other side, but this time we'll set the extension line to minus 10 centimeters. In the list of imported furniture, we notice that the height of the lower cabinets is 88.5 centimeters. To show this in the plan, select the Create Dimensions button, point near a cabinet, and hold the Control key while pressing the left mouse button. In the Add Dimension window that appears, Elevation Dimension is selected. Enter 0.885 meters in the Distance Between Endpoints field and press the OK button. In the list of furniture, right-click on the heading. From the menu that appears, point to display column and select elevation. We notice that the upper cupboards start at a height of 1.45 meters. To show this in our plan, activate the Add Dimensions button and, while holding down the Control key, left-click on the bench. In the window that appears, enter 88.5 centimeters in the elevation field and the operation 1.45 meters, minus 88.5 centimeters in the distance between endpoints field. This will display the distance of the upper cabinets from the counter in our plan. Similarly, you can add any measurements you find useful to capture your design in detail. For instance, displaying the entire length of one side of the kitchen might be beneficial. Sweet Home 3D empowers cabinet makers to explore various kitchen layout options digitally by designing alternative layouts on new levels. This allows you to present multiple design solutions to your clients, increasing the chances of finding a layout that perfectly matches their vision and preferences. After designing all your alternative proposals on different levels, you are ready to create images of these designs. You can then send them to clients for approval or to discuss and revise specific aspects of your proposals. Before proceeding, it's important to change the length units to those that your customers understand. To do this, go to the File menu and select Preferences. In the window that appears, choose the appropriate length measurement unit from the unit options list. Additionally, ensure that the option Aerial View Centered on Selection is selected, so the chosen object appears in the center of the 3D view. Also, select Selection and Editing in 3D view to easily select and edit the upper and lower cabinets in the 3D view. Make both the floor plan level and one of the kitchen layouts viewable. Then, select the kitchen level. Right-click on the 3D view and select Aerial View if it is not already selected. Press and hold the left mouse button to choose the desired point of view, and use the mouse wheel to adjust the zoom level. After making your adjustments, press the Create a Photo from 3D View button on the toolbar. In the window that appears, enter the width and height in pixels. Select the Keep Proportions checkbox and choose a 16:9 aspect ratio or any other desired aspect ratio from the list. For photo quality, select Fast or the second value on the slider, noting that the second option includes shadows beneath the furniture. Finally, press the Create button. After creating the photo, press the Save button. Choose the folder where you want to save the photo, or create a new folder if you haven't already. Repeat this process for other points of view or for other kitchen layouts. Finally, you can create a PDF file that includes the furniture list, floor plan, and 3D views. Go to the File menu and select Print to PDF. In the window that appears, choose the folder where you want to save the PDF and enter the file name. Let's open the folder that Mr. Jones created for his client Future Home. Sweet Home 3D can transform your inspiration from an abstract dream into an accurate guide for your perfect kitchen layout. With its intuitive tools and features, you can ensure that every detail meets your functional and aesthetic needs. All this valuable information, including detailed plans and 3D views, can be easily shared via email or other methods. We'll explore these sharing options, as well as tips for refining your design, in the next videos. Don't miss the next lesson on 3D Logic class, where we'll discuss kitchen cabinet materials. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Feel free to leave your questions and comments below. I'd love to hear your thoughts and help you with any design challenges. Thanks for watching.